Hi, my name is Jürgen and I love open source software. Today I'm going to take you to Inkscape. Inkscape is one of my favorite graphic programs. It's a vector program, and in this program today I'm going to teach you about what layers, paths and objects are. It's a really simple concept because in Inkscape you work with shapes. So every shape has certain properties. For example, the sun here has a border, has a fill, and you could give it an outline. So now it's a thick outline, but I don't want to have it to give an outline. So a shape has one distinct color. So if you have like the flowers here, as you see, they have multiple colors. They have an inner side and a outer the petals. So this shape is an object. An object consists of one or more paths, and these I have grouped them together, so they are a unit. I have a few shapes here, so these are shapes. You can recognize a shape if you look at the bottom here. You see the word path. So this is a path. This is a path. This is a path. This one, it's a group. There are three objects in there. This one is a group of two objects. So you can have a path or you can have a group. Obviously, you can also have other things, like if you say I have a text, sunset at Inkscape. I'm going to grow this a little bit. Now you see here it says it's a text and you have some basic properties. Now, what's the fun thing about this way of working? For example, if you say I want to have the sun here, or I want to have it here, so you can move every object wherever you want it. If you want to move this group here, you can. If you want to change some of these flowers, you can. You can even change the size of them if you would want to. So this is the concept of line objects, of paths. And so now there's one little annoying thing. So imagine I want to select all these flowers. I could make a big rectangle, but it's really hard to select them because I'll end up also having selected the green patch. I don't want this to happen, so I'm gonna create layers. So if I go to menu, you see I have layer here. I'm gonna, at the bottom, use the show layer menu, so the layer menu, and it appears here. And now you see, by default, you only have one layer. I'm gonna call this background. I'm gonna rename it. So I just double clicked on it. And I'm gonna add a new layer. And I'm gonna put in there flowers. So now I'm gonna select the part of the flowers here. I'm gonna cut them, Control X. And I'm going to paste them in the same place by using Alt Control V. Of course, I have to be in the correct layer. Alt Control V. Now I'm going to go back to this layer. I'm going to select the other half of the flowers. Control X. Alt Control V. Okay, so now our flowers are in place. So now what happens is that I could say I'm going to block the background, so I won't be able to move anything except in the flower layer. This is really handy if you want to prevent certain parts from moving. So for example, if you say I really don't want the sky and the grass to move, okay, I'm going to create an extra layer. Mountain. It's the Inkscape logo, by the way. So mountain. Add it. So I'm going to unlock this layer again. I'm going to cut it. I'm going to paste it here in place. Alt Control V. Why do I say Alt Control V? If I just do Control V, it will place it somewhere relatively, depending on where your mouse is. So we want it to have the same place. So we're going to use Alt Control V. And this way you can start blocking certain items. You could, for example, if you say I want the sun to be a little bit more transparent, so I'm going to cut it, I'm going to put it in a new layer too. Sun, Alt Control V. Hey, come on. So I'm going to select it. And if I move it, oh. Select. It still works, but oh, it's going in front of the grass. So this is a little bit annoying. So I'll have to set different layers again. So it can get complicated. So I'm going to make a separate layer for the sky. But this has to go in front like this, okay? And this one, it has to go behind the background. Okay, now I think we're getting somewhere. One last thing, I would like to have this text. I'm also going to put it in a separate layer. I love to use layers, because now I'm going to make it really big. Wait. Okay, it's in the layer text. And I'm going to add some opacity, so it's getting transparent and the colors come through. You could say, okay, now I'm not sure if I like the flowers, I'm gonna hide them for a moment. Okay, maybe I prefer the mountain to be behind the flowers. Yeah, that's better. And this way I can play with all these layers. I can lock the ones I don't want to use. If I have a really complex image, I can even temporarily hide layers. You have different blend modes. If you say I wanted to work with multiplication, this is only works, of course, if you have like a color, or if you work with color dodge or color burn. You can use all these kinds of layer effects, and this way you could very easily have different effects on different layers, as you can see. So this is the really important concept behind Inkscape. So you have layers, it's like slides from the past. You have an object, and an object consists of different paths. A path is one shape that has an outline, a fill color, and a borderline. So I could, I'll just show that last detail with the background. I'll unlock it. I could say, if I click here on this item here in the bottom, I get the fill and stroke menu. So you could also conjure it with Shift Control F. So I have a fill. This is a color that is defined. I can give it a stroke paint. So I'm going to give it a nice dark green borderline. I can make it a dash thicker if I want to. I could even give it a pattern, and this way you could decorate the way you want. So this is layers, groups of the layers, paths, and objects. Have fun with Inkscape, and see you next time in our second episode of Ink Myscape. Bye.